I've been debating whether to share something that happened to me that was a bit like a profound soul earthquake. And I think this is the 23rd year in Eureka. I think I should share this because it's so germane, not only to this room, but I think kind of on a macro level, perhaps what the whole earth is going to have to go through. On April 9th, 1983, I was inside of that OSI office at Kurland Air Force Base. And I was handed those dozen pages by the man saying his superiors had asked him to show this to me. And it was supposed to be an alleged briefing paper for the President of the United States, all caps, without identifying what president or what date. But it began with a very dry historic summary of the Mantell case, the man who tried to chase the 100 or 200 or 300 foot diameter disc, and his plane ended up in 1,000 pieces riddled with holes that were later described as having interacted with a microwave energy. And it went into crash retrievals and a list of where we had retrieved discs from many places. And around the third page, in the middle paragraph, to my complete astonishment, I was reading in black text, double spaced, 2,000 years ago, these extraterrestrial biological entities created a being to be placed on this planet to teach Homo sapiens about love and nonviolence. And the next three sentences, I can only give you the gist because I was so stunned by that first sentence. The next three sentences in that paragraph were that with that being, two others were placed on the planet and Homo sapiens killed all three. And I looked up at that moment to Richard Doty sitting behind the desk, and I said, we're talking about Jesus Christ here. And he only nodded, and his face turned very red. And I only learned later, about 10 years later, that I was videotaped and audiotaped throughout that entire session. And when this long office of exposure to content in this paper that included another Project Garnet, because I made myself remember my birthday is in January and my birthstone is Garnet, and on that paper it said Project Garnet. All questions and mysteries about the evolution of Homo sapien on this planet have been answered and this project is closed. And that was sort of the button to the other paragraph, including another one that said that the extraterrestrials had created the entire dinosaur evolution on the planet. So my mind that afternoon was ringing with Christ came with two others defined as extraterrestrials and we killed them. All questions and mysteries about the evolution of Homo sapiens have been answered, and that we're dealing with intelligences that created all of the dinosaurs that would go back at least 270 million years. And I had to leave the FOSI office and go to my car, and I was scheduled to go on, and I had a rental car. I had to go now back into human life and do all those things that you have to do to return a rental car, and I got on a bus, and I went to a city where there were some friends that were going to meet, and the whole idea was to spend a week together on mutilations and a whole bunch of stuff. So by the time I got home, where I lived with a husband and a young daughter then, in Littleton, Colorado, I realized that something had so cracked inside of me that I felt almost on the verge of tears at all time, and I'm not a teary person. But I wasn't aware consciously of what it was, truly. And I remember getting home late, and my husband said, why don't you go and do prayers with Laura, because we weren't brought up in a church, but I really have always had this really close alliance with what I consider to be the force of all life. And that's what I was trying to share with my daughter every night. So I hadn't seen her for a while. And I hope I can get through this without crying. This is not what I, this is not my intent, but this is so important to share, I think. I went into her room and it was dark and I had been gone for a long time and she was really happy to see me. And I always sang a lullaby and then I did this prayer. This is so weird, I have so much emotion. And the prayer always started, Holy Father, Holy Mother, Chi, and that's as far as I could go. And I couldn't say Jesus Christ. And I was sitting there in the dark, and my daughter said, Mom, what's wrong? This is weird. I didn't know this was here. So I somehow kept going. And I hugged her. And I walked out of the room and I shut the door. And we had a stair, a big stairway. And I remember I grabbed a hold of the stair and I fell to my knees and I was sobbing to, have you ever sobbed so hard that it feels like you're vomiting? But I didn't want to make any noise. And it actually, I remember the pain. And I'm hanging on to the knob, and what is rushing through my head over and over are the words from that briefing paper. And then it was as if something took a hold of me that was much larger. And what came into my mind was, what difference does it make if Christ is an extraterrestrial? And all of a sudden, there was just like warm water. I felt healed. I felt strong. I got up. And from that moment on, it's never been an issue. I didn't know I carried that much emotion. But I'm sharing this because I think that what I went through from the briefing paper, the travel, the getting back, that I wasn't aware of how much it had affected me, and that my convulsing sobs on my knees is what I think that the whole planet, at some level, in all spiritual relationships to the universe, will have to go through. And I share it to say that something took hold of me and move me right through it, and I've never been stronger than from that moment.